Kiss FM.
For Monday, Elon Musk has become the richest person on the planet following Tesla's $1 trillion valuation after an estimated $25.6 billion fortune boost that happened on Friday when Hertz announced plans to buy 100,000 electric cars from Tesla to use as rentals. Now, Tesla shares grew 12% this morning to roughly $1,025, making Elon worth $289 billion. He has now pushed the gap between himself and Jeff Bezos to $96 billion. And over the weekend, with the news of Musk's increase in net worth, CNN and other news outlets began reporting that 2% of Musk's net worth, which would be $6 billion, could solve world hunger. Now, there was some debate, but Musk himself took to Twitter with a simple message and said, if the UN's World Food Program can describe on this Twitter thread exactly how $6 billion will solve world hunger, I will sell Tesla stock right now and do it. But it must be open source accounting so that the public sees precisely how the money is spent. Well, the UN World Food Program chief David Beasley responded to Musk's tweet saying $6 billion will not solve world hunger, but it will prevent geopolitical instability, mass migration, and save 42 million people on the brink of starvation, saying, you know, an unprecedented crisis and a perfect storm due to COVID conflict and climate crisis. He did say, with your help, we can bring hope, build stability, and change the future. He also assured Elon Musk that the UN's World Food Program has systems in place to remain transparent when it comes to spending money. So now we'll have to see if Elon responds and makes something happen. That was all happening yesterday on Twitter. Now, here's something else. Ice Cube reportedly backed out of $9 million. He turned down a $9 million paycheck because he refused to get vaccinated. He was supposed to star opposite Jack Black in the comedy Oh Hell No, but decided he would rather step away from the project than comply with a production mandate to get the vaccine. Now, sources did say that by walking away from the film, he turned his back on $9 million. Now, while reports indicate that Ice Cube was reluctant to get the vaccine, you remember he's been a strong proponent of mask advocacy throughout the pandemic. He unveiled a brand of Check Yourself Before You Wreck Yourself t-shirts that featured him in a mask that were designed to benefit frontline workers. And he also donated personal protective equipment, including 2,000 face masks. It was a great weekend for Jay-Z. He was inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame by Obama and Dave Chappelle. Hove's introduction video was packed with a lot of famous faces, including Beyonce, Chris Rock, Diddy, Samuel Jackson, LeBron, and more. And there was another pre-recorded message from former President Barack Obama, and then Dave Chappelle delivered Jay-Z's formal induction speech. Obama said, I've turned to Jay-Z's words at different points in my life, whether I was brushing dirt off my shoulder on the campaign trail or sampling his lyric in the Edmund Pettus Bridge on the 50th anniversary of the Selma March to Montgomery. Today, Jay-Z is one of the most renowned artists in history and an embodiment of the American dream, a dream he has helped make real for other young people like him. Dave Chappelle said that Jay-Z, I need everybody in rock and roll to know that even though you are honoring him, he is ours. He is hip-hop forever and ever and a day. And during his speech, Jay-Z actually shouted out Dame Dash, which a lot of people were kind of shocked about. He said, I know we don't see eye to eye, but I can never erase your accomplishments. I appreciate you and thank you for that. And that's your Juicy Entertainment News for Monday. Lock it in again tomorrow for more of the juice right here on the all-new KISS 96.